Hi, my name is Dr. Seema Shah Fairbank, and in this video I'll be presenting an overview of hydrology. After watching this video, you'll be able to differentiate hydrology from engineering hydrology, and you'll also be able to describe the limiting factors to hydrology. As you enter this module, you're thinking, what is hydrology? I hope water comes to your mind. Hydrology is the study of water. It encompasses the currents, how often is there water, the distribution, where is the water within the system, for example, is it in the air, surface, or soil, the movement, how is the water transported, and the properties, is it solid, liquid, or gas. But why do engineers care about hydrology? I hope you're thinking about the need for design, at least. But there's more to engineering hydrology than just design. We need to also consider the operation of engineering projects. Both design and operation helps control, use, and develop solution to problems associated with too much or too little water. We do this since water is essential for life as we know it. Dams and reservoirs are used for water supply, energy creation, and flood control. The Glen Canyon Dam, which created Lake Powell upstream of the Colorado River, was built in 1966. It can hold 27 million acre-feet of water. Not only does it generate electricity, but it also provides a water supply source. Elephant Butte Reservoir, located in New Mexico, falls along the Rio Grande River. It was built in 1916 to provide power and irrigation to southern, central New Mexico and western Texas. It holds 2 million acre feet of water. The outlet structure of Long Lake Dam, located on the Spokane River, provides an example of how dams are controlled. The gates shown can be opened as closed as needed to ensure downstream water supply and make sure that the upstream reservoir does not overtop the dam. Long Lake Dam was built in 1915 to supply power. Prado Dam, which is located in our own backyards in Chino Hill, California, is created from flows by the Santa Ana River. Its primary purpose when built in 1941 was flood control. In addition to flood control, the dam is currently being used to hold water and provide flows downstream for groundwater recharge and habitat restoration. We're also responsible for the design of rivers, canals, and drainage ditches to control flows of water. The LA River was lined with concrete in the late 1930s to control flows due to prior flooding, which was devastating to Southern California. The Mississippi River is one of the most important navigation rivers in the United States. Levees line the river on both sides to prevent flows from flooding the region. Drainage ditches and mini canals are other ways to control flows to desired locations. All of this helps control flows for human use. Culverts with head walls and wing walls allow flows to travel under roadways. Curbs and roadway transport flows to cut out curb sections, catch basins, and graded inlets. The flows are transported then to storm drain systems that discharge water into waterways, such as rivers. Flows are also being transported through swales above ground and provide water quality benefits. As engineers, we design and operate all these different devices. But there are many factors that can impact hydrology. As engineers and hydrologists, we're constantly trying to predict how much available water we have at any given time. As we consider this, we are faced with uncertainty. This is because we don't know what will happen tomorrow. It might rain, it might not. Thus, we use statistics to predict the future. Climate change is impacting our prediction as we are facing more extreme climate events. Economics plays a role in design. If we had all the money in the world, we can make our infrastructure indestructible. But this is not the case. We design our projects for a design life. For example, the service life of a well-designed, well-constructed, and well-maintained and monitored concrete dam can easily reach 100 years. However, the hydromechanical elements, such as the gates and their motors, have to be replaced every 30 to 50 years. Finally, there's a lack of theory and our observed data. As hydrologists and engineers, we're faced with trying to predict and understand Mother Nature. We fit mathematical models to natural phenomena. This is helpful, but cannot always be accurate. In addition, data is not available for us to make the needed predictions for the future. Regardless of all of this, we are faced to develop solutions, even in the presence of many limitations that exist. I hope that after this mini lesson, you have a better understanding of your role as an engineer and the various limitations you will need to think about as you complete complex projects.